What's up, guys? Stuck the Duck here, and welcome to the first entry of my brand new series on the channel, Clash Concepts. In this series, I will show you guys some conceptual ideas that I have for Corporate Clash's future updates. Now, to clarify, I don't expect any of these ideas to actually show up in-game, but I think they're interesting enough to share with all of you. So without further ado, let's jump into the very first episode, my take on the Overclocked CFO fight. Let's start with the first cog round. After a fun new cutscene where Mata Hari gives you a rundown of the CFO's upgraded defenses, the toons will split into four groups of two, where each group is greeted by a brand new cog type that's going to be the primary highlight of Overclocked CFO cog battles. This cog will have a very non-lifelike appearance, and will have the Fat Cog body type. While I'm sure Corporate Clash would come up with a much better name for these menacing guardian cogs, for the purposes of this video, I'm going to name them Sentinels. Now let's get into the Sentinels' attributes. Each Sentinel is level 25 EXE, which is the equivalent of 1,053 health for the cog. These cogs also introduce a brand new status effect called Guardian, which disables cease and desist and pink slips. As long as a Sentinel is in the battle, all other regular cogs will be protected by this status effect. As soon as there are no Sentinels remaining, this effect is erased from all cogs immediately. When it comes to Sentinel attack patterns, they will either use one attack move along with one cheat, or one strong attack move with no cheat. It's also important to note that Sentinels only attack using AoEs. The weak AoE does 12 damage, and the strong AoE does 24 damage to toons. You may be wondering about the specific cheats, but we'll touch upon those later in the video, as the Sentinel cheats do not apply to the first round. And finally, Sentinels do have lure resistance. They will only stay alert for 3 rounds if accompanied by another Sentinel or Manager, but will only stay alert for 2 rounds if they are by themselves, not including regular cogs. Given the nature of the first round, their lure resistance will remain at 2 for the entire round. While each pair of toons fights against their Sentinel, regular cashbot cogs will fly out of a giant vault door to each pairing, averaging 8 cogs per pair. Which isn't many, but due to the nature of only 2 toons per group, this will be just as substantial and about as long as the first round of the Overclocked CLO. Now, you may want to protest, Stuck, this is very unreasonable. What about lureless toons? With only 2 toons per group, it is very likely that you'll have pairs with no lure at all. And yes, I do recognize that, but in this concept, I wanted to create something that is unique and new. We saw with the 1.2 update that the Clash team completely redefined the meta as far as ideal gag builds. And in this conceptual OCFO edition, you'd see yet another ripple effect in the meta, which keeps things fresh. Now that players know what to expect with a hard mode boss fight, completely new concepts need to be introduced, rather than another predictable first round in lieu of the Overclocked CLO. After all the cogs are defeated from the first round, this will transition into the manager round. Frustrated by his new sentinels being easily thwarted by the toons, the CFO enlists 2 of his new subservients from the Federal Reserve. This differs from the Overclocked CLO litigation team fight in a very specific way. Instead of fighting a pair of managers, each group of toons will fight 1 of 4 Federal Reserve managers alongside a singular sentinel. That means while there will still be 4 new manager cogs, only 2 random managers will make an appearance for each Overclocked CFO fight. And of course, each manager will have a unique battle theme specific to them, similar to the Overclocked CLO. Thank you in advance, Master Frasca. Now since the Sentinels make a reappearance, we need to address their brand new attributes that take place in this round that did not take place in the first round. Firstly, all Sentinel attributes from round 1 apply here. Additionally, a new Sentinel will join the battle every 3 rounds. If there are 4 cogs in battle and 3 rounds go by, the Sentinel will increase the cog limit to 5, similar to the Litigator's Bayou Bash attack. But there is a limit to this, as there can only be a max of 3 Sentinels in the battle at one time. For each Sentinel in the battle, the Federal Reserve Manager will take 20% less damage from all gags. This status effect is immediately revoked if a Sentinel is defeated. It's important to keep in mind, as the more Sentinels that stack up in battle, the harder it's going to be to deal damage to the Manager. Let's introduce the 3 Sentinel cheats that'll take place in the Manager round. Safety Deposit. The Sentinel will take 50% less damage for 2 rounds. File Bankruptcy. If the Sentinel reaches below 300 HP in a round, it will file bankruptcy and sacrifice itself to give its remaining HP to the Federal Reserve Manager. A way for toons to circumvent this cheat is to make sure the Sentinel doesn't reach below 300 HP before dealing the final blow to the cog. And finally, Mandatory Meeting. The Sentinel will order 2 regular cogs to join the battle. The Sentinel will only use this cheat if there are 4 cogs or less, potentially increasing the cog limit to a maximum of 6. And remember, you cannot fire or sue these cogs as long as Sentinels are in the battle. And that's it for the Sentinels' cheats. Once the Federal Reserve manager has been defeated, Sentinels and regular cogs will no longer spawn. The only exception to this rule is that Sentinels can still use the mandatory meeting cheat to bring two regular cogs into battle. As for specific cheats from the Federal Reserve managers, leave a comment below what you'd like to see from a Cashbot manager. Try to keep them Cashbot themed, as I really like how Clash keeps things themed through the cog departments. But once all those cogs are destroyed, that wraps up the manager round. Now, with the addition of this new boss fight, we will also be introduced to a minigame round for the Overclocked CFO in lieu of the CLO's Cannon round and the CEO's Banquet round. I think the minigames really add essential variety to Toontown boss battles, especially given that they impact future rounds in the fight. So, allow me to introduce the brand new minigame round. Following the destruction of the Federal Reserve managers, the panicked CFO will escape to the room to the left of the entrance elevator. Matahari is struck with a new idea as she leads the Toons into the room where the boss round of the regular CFO takes place. Matahari warns that this room has been rigged with goons, and that Toons need to collect as many goons as possible to create a surprise attack for the CFO. Mata then sets up a giant cart in the middle of the room, where the CFO would usually sit, and Toons have 90 seconds to use the cranes to throw goons into the cart. Since the CFO isn't present, the goons will enter the room from the metal doors, and only red and purple goons will spawn. This means that Toons need to be careful, and there needs to be dedicated goon stunners for the craners. This also means that for the very first time, there is a possibility that Toons may go sad in the minigame round. Once the timer is up, this will conclude the round, and we will finally be moving on to the final round, formerly known as the boss round. Matahari will instruct the Toons to follow her as she leaps into the cart and drives it to the CFO's quarters. The Toons run after her and arrive at the CFO's hiding spot, a large room filled with coin bags, safes, and four cranes. Before the CFO can react, Matahari flips a big red switch on her cart. This deploys a cannon, which launches a ball of goons directly at the CFO. The CFO is struck and takes damage. The damage dealt to the CFO is dependent on how many goons were collected in the minigame round, and this attack starts off the boss round with a slight advantage based on the Toon's performance in the previous round. The CFO is angered, and in a last-ditch effort, he orders his final security measure to help him take on the Toons, flying goons. These bots introduce a whole new aspect to the boss fight, so let's discuss their attributes first. The flying goons carry safes, and the Toons must use cranes to throw coin bags at the flying goons, which knocks them down, freeing the safe. As expected, flying goons' light beam deals damage to Toons, so beware about that. Also, there are only four safes in this room, but also only four flying goons. After a safe is thrown, it is immediately collected by a flying goon, and it must be freed again. And finally, flying goons cannot be picked up by cranes. Now with these new enemies introduced, let's go over the boss round objective. As in most Toontown boss fights, there are two roles for the Toons, Craners and CFO Taunters. Craners must use the cranes to throw coin bags at the CFO, which deals small amounts of damage to him and has the chance to stun him. Basically, coin bags work the same as goons would in a regular CFO. As mentioned earlier, Craners also use coin bags against flying goons in order to free up safes to deal massive damage to the CFO while he's stunned. Toons can also choose to taunt the CFO via a gag never before seen in a boss round, Tune Up. Toons will be provided tune-up canes for Matahari, and they can use the cane to dance nearby the CFO, and in annoyance, he will move towards the dancing Toons. Taunting is important, as the CFO actually moves around in the overclocked fight, and taunters must keep the CFO away from cranes, or else he will run them over, disabling them, similar to how the CEO can run over tables. Matahari will repair any broken cranes, but she can only repair them one at a time, so plan accordingly. Now, let's look into the CFO's overclocked attributes. The CFO will start with 2,500 HP, minus the amount of bonus damage based on the minigame round. As stated before, he can move around the battlefield, which can make craning slightly more difficult. The CFO will also put a safe on his head every time he is unstunned, and as always, it must be knocked off before any damage can be dealt to the CFO. As for attacks, he would obviously have all the attacks he'd have in a normal fight. Additionally, he now has the coin spin attack, which is the spin attack that all other bosses have. The CFO can also jump, and craners must step away from their cranes and jump in time to avoid taking damage from this. The CFO is also equipped with a brand new attack called Make It Rain. The CFO will throw coins up into the air, and the coins will rain down all across the battlefield in columns. This is similar to the attack specialist in the Overclocked CLO, but the targets are smaller, and there are many more of them. The CFO also has a rare attack. There is a rare chance that the CFO will order two trains to drive right through the cranes. Toons must act fast when they are alerted to avoid getting hit. This attack also disables all four cranes, and Matahari must repair them. Although this attack is rare, there will never be an overclocked CFO where this attack is not used at least once. And that's it. Once the CFO's health has been reduced to zero, the Toons win. The CFO will try to retreat, but will be met with his usual fate. Matt and Harry will thank Toons for their help, and they will receive an executive promotion. They will also be rewarded with a special prize, Jelly Bean Unites. And that, my friends, is my clash concept for the Overclocked CFO. Let me know what you guys thought of all of this, as this video took a really long time to create. But I think it turned out great in the end. Also, don't forget to subscribe and to leave a comment telling me what you'd like to see from the Federal Reserve Manager Cheats. That's all for me for now, and as always, I'll see you in the playground, losers.